and welcome follow subscribers and other racing fans. This is the AOR race from Brands Hatch. And as everybody knows, a very, very difficult track containing many opportunities where you can throw away your car, crash into the walls or just spin out. So the goal for this one was not to do this. However, again, in qualifying we were pretty slow. Got only P10. However, that didn't keep me from improving a lot during the races in the past. Okay, the race is starting. I'll see you on the other side. Enjoy!
10th position. Get ready, mate. It's hammer time. Car left. You're in the middle. Clear right. Left side. Three wide. You're in the middle. Clear right. Clear all around. On your right. He's still there. Clear right. Car left. Clear left.
There was already some hairy scenes there. We stuck together with another guy. And now I'm behind two Astons. Hope we catch the pack. Yes, do.
Car left. Clear left. Car right. Right side's clear. Car right. Clear right.
Well, couldn't do anything about that. There was a, like in a beginning traffic jam. We were starting to brake earlier and earlier and earlier. I couldn't brake early enough. Usually
left side.
Oh, that was
clear
close.
Left. Nice move, mate.
Usually I get some positions in the starting phases, however. Around here I got some and I also
left
lost
side.
Some.
Clear left.
Very the dangerous situation.
26.2. That's your fastest lap. Your tyre temperatures look good.
The curb. Only thing I can do right now is right behind. I mean, you can't overtake anyway. But, also, the slipstream. Huge aerodynamic problems. And another one off track.
Good.
It was Pedro.
He was second place on the crit.
Last lap was a 1:25.2. That's the fastest lap of the race. You're looking really good. Come on, keep your focus. Your tyre temperatures are okay.
Oh, those curbs. If it's braking a little earlier than I do, a bit dangerous situation. I won't overtake you in this corner anyway, Jellyfish. Don't go defensive. Ooh. That was very, very dangerous. What Jörg did there was, couldn't do anything about it, but in very dangerous situation at port.
Right side.
Come on, Jellyfish. I get you.
Still there. Still there. Clear right.
There was a clear pass. Oversteering.
Car left. Clear left.
Ooh, that was dangerous. Know what Jellyfish meant to do there. Okay, fifth place. Jordi's very slow on the straights, maybe he has aerodynamic damage.
On your right. Clear right. On your right.
I got a little close to him now, that was not good. I should have known better, but he's so slow and we are losing the guys in front, so I needed to do something about that. He's going very defensive, desperate to keep his position. I think I'm a bit better out of this corner for most part. I feel like I'm somewhat faster, but I can't do anything because I can't overtake on this freaking track. Come on, steady fish.
That was a 1:26.6. Clear left. Left side. He's still there. Clear left.
1:04. Now we need to close the gap to jellyfish again. Which doesn't seem to work right now. Definitely has some pace at the moment.
Your lap times are improving, this is good. Brake temperatures are looking good. That last lap was a 1:24.7. Your tyre temps are looking good.
Closing the gap there. where I tried to slip through. A nice fight. A little mistake from me. Sorry for not talking too much, but it's that needs full concentration there. Definitely. What some dirty air. He's really strong in this second to last corner. Huge oversteer. No! The dirty air is huge once you get caught in it. That was almost a spin.
The leader has just done a 1:24.1. That was at 1:25.8.
Not that you think I gave up overtaking Jellyfish, but it's not possible to drive all the time in the slipstream of another driver. You lose all your aerodynamic grip. And therefore it's very, very dangerous. Yeah, the Yorkie defense earlier, I mean, it was okay. Remember, he has quite some damage, so He knew that he would be overtaken eventually. I would not have taken so much of a fight. We're losing some time. I can't find a place where I can safely overtake. Not in turn one. Definitely not.
The guy behind has just done a 1:24.6. Car left. He's still there. Clear left. Your lap times are improving. Faster stuff, we'll have some more of that.
It's not very clean for me. I mean, I was beside him, but kind of knew that would break a little bit late and therefore get some understeering, and this was what was happening. I got understeering and Jellyfish didn't count on that. So he turned in and hit me.
Your brake temperatures are fine, mate.
Before. To adjust my driving a little bit now. You don't have anyone in front of you, guiding you.
Fastest lap. Your tire temperatures are okay.
Not doing too great here. Also not too
we estimate grabby. About 29 more laps out of this set of tires.
That's not too great.
That's your fastest lap today.
Do have a problem with turn one though.
Wait.
Jellyfish has to defend against Mazi now. That's exactly the problem. Well, I would have had. I was in his position. Oh, Mazi spy. But it costs both of them some time. looks like.
That lap was a 1:24.8. Your lap times are improving, this is good.
We can't catch Rami Boo. The same strategy or same pace, I wanted to say. And Maisie's coming closer, very quick. Of course, he is an M3.
You've just done a 1:25.2. The guy behind has just done a 1:24.4.
Quite a good sector one. Oh, Messi spawn. Behind us.
Good lap. That's your quickest today.
So yeah, we will be going into the pits as well. Not quite yet, though. 22 in lap 22, in lap 23. We will go into the pits in lap 23. That's what we will do. I do feel quite comfortable right now, however, I know the tires will give up in a few laps. Always like that. Experience, if you want it like that.
That was a 1:25.1. Your left rear showing significant wear. Good consistency. Keep them coming.
Yeah, on the brakes, rear is already coming around. man, Yorkie really has some bad luck with his races. Disconnects already, the damage today. It's always something.
You're locking your front right.
Ow. My thumb really hurts. Cramping a little bit. Okay, lap times are falling off already, so go into the pits now. Should be okay.
The leader's pitting now.
So hopefully I don't miss the pit entry. Would be a shame. No, I didn't. Okay. Oh man, I have much too much fuel on board. Much too much. Damn it. Why do I have so much more fuel?
Half distance. Fuel looks good. There's traffic behind. Keep your wits about you.
What happened to F1 Massa? Why is he behind me? Why do I have to fight him now?
On your left. Clear left.
Oh, it was a good idea to go into the pits. That would be so much better. Only thing I don't like is F1 Massa behind me.
Your tires are fine, mate. Just push. Right side. Clear right.
I didn't lose or gain on running two. sure if I should fight Massa.
Your brake temperatures are fine, mate.
Woo!
Last lap was at 124.5.
Damn it.
Your tire temperatures look good.
Well, that question is answered. I locked up wheels there. I mean, I think it's for the better. Oh man. Airs are locking up now. Every corner. Not like that.
Right, clear right.
Oh no, Massa crashed. Massa crashed. Oh no, Massa disconnect. Oh no, everyone gets disconnected. Oh, come on. What the fuck? Oh. That is... Yeah. The session is falling apart. You can see it. Come on. It's so stupid. It's so stupid.
Okay, there's that. As you can see, you can't see anything. Mass disconnects in a lap 27 of 45. So what happens next? The AOR rules state that if more than 50% of the race distance was driven and there is a mass disconnect happening, the race will count, however, with half the points. Results are taken from the last lap before the disconnects were happening. So I was in P5 at this point and, what should I say, quite happy about the result. Coming from P10, P5 is okay and we had some nice fights, we had some nice consistency and some nice overtakings. Hope you enjoyed as well and see you next time. Bye bye.